Yeah, students, now we are going to discuss regarding permanent hardness of water. Previously we had a discussion regarding hard water, soft water and methods used for the removal of temporary hardness. Now we are going to discuss regarding permanent hardness of the water. So first, what are the methods we are using for the removal of permanent hardness? And once again, remember, what are the salts responsible for permanent hardness of the water? So the salts which are responsible for permanent hardness of the water are only four. They are MgSO4, MgCl2, CaSO4, and CaCl2. So we have to remove by using different methods these four salts. The methods are what? One, by adding washing soda. Second one, Firmitude process. Third one, Colgon process. And fourth one is ion exchange resin method. Now later discuss one by one. The first method is by using washing soda. Hydrated sodium carbonate, also called washing soda. Hydrated sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, 10H2O, called as washing soda. So in this process, and one special point, by using washing soda we can remove temporary hardness as well as permanent hardness. This bit is repeated in competitive examination. Like, which of the following substance is used for removal of temporary hardness as well as permanent hardness? The answer is what? Washing soda. So in this process, water is treated with calculated amount of washing soda, which converts whatever chlorides, sulfates, bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium are there, converts into what? Insoluble carbonates. Just see the reactions, one by one reaction. CaCl2 Na2CO3 CaCO3 precipitate, MgCl2 Na2CO3 MgCO3 precipitate, MgSO4 Na2CO3 gives us to MgCO3 precipitate, similarly CaCO3 precipitate. So these are the salts responsible for permanent hardness of the water. In similar way, By using washing soda, we can remove temporary hardness also. Na2CO3 can also be used for removal of temporary hardness. See the reaction. Bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium, treated with sodium carbonate, you will get calcium carbonate, magnesium carbonate precipitate. These precipitates can be separated by using filtration process. So anyway, one competitive bit is what? By using sodium carbonate or washing soda, we can remove temporary hardness as well as permanent hardness. Now let us discuss one of the most important method, very important concepts. Just check once, the method name is Permitude process, also Gans Permitude process, also base exchange method. These are the other names. And the first point in this process, this is a modern method for the softening of hard water. This is the modern method. Next point, Permitude is the technical name. It's a technical name given to certain hydrated silicates of aluminium and sodium. Hydrated silicates of aluminium and sodium, and this can be obtained by using sodium carbonate, china clay and silica or quartz. Next point is very important one. Hydrated sodium aluminium silicate is called permitute. Hydrated sodium aluminium silicate is called permitute. Permitude formula is Na2Al2Si2O8XH2O. artificially prepared permittivity is called zeolite. Artificially prepared permittivity is called what? Zeolite. Now, when hot water is passed through a permittivity, whatever calcium and magnesium salts present in the water are exchanged by Na plus ions present in the permittivity. See these four reactions. This is the permittivity. These are the salts for the hardness responsible salts. Na2, Al2, Si2, O8 plus MgCl2. Here two sodium ions are exchanged by Mg because sodium carrying only one positive charge and magnesium carries plus two charge. So here two sodiums are replaced by one magnesium and calcium. Similarly, check these four reactions. In this process, so simply just imagine when hard water is passed through a bed of permittivity, when hard water is passed through a bed of permittivity, permittivity exchanges magnesium and calcium ions present in the hard water. So here sodium ions are replaced by calcium and magnesium. After some time, when total sodium ions are replaced by magnesium and calcium, the permittivity not going to function. So that is called exhausted permittivity. And another very important bit, what is the formula of exhausted permittivity? Exhausted permittivity formula is what? MgAl2Si2O8 or CaAl2Si2O8. So how to regenerate exhausted permittivity? How to regenerate the exhausted permittivity? Exhausted permittivity is regenerated by washing or soaking with brine solution. Take the exhausted permittivity. When it is treated with brine solution, again you will get permittivity. So 10% of the sodium chloride solution is called brine solution. This is the formula of exhausted permittivity. MgAl2Si2O8 or CaAl2Si2O8. Treatment with brine solution, you are getting Na2Al2Si2O8, and this can use. Okay, this is the what? Recovery, regeneration of permittivity. Still two more methods there. The methods are what? Colgon method and ion exchange resin method. Okay, I will send those two methods in part 3. Okay.